Who is Aaron Smith, Highlander number 175?
I am a cheeky Māori boy from Fielding, and I came down here to, you know, follow my dream. My dream was to play Super Rugby, and when I got here, Jamie Joe really challenged me about, you could be more, you could do better, you could be an All Black. And then the dream changed, and my goals and stuff changed, and he saw something in me that made me look higher than I'd anticipated. And for me, it was just to play Super Rugby and try and see if I could prove it at that level. And he said, you can be way better. And I didn't think he was right at the time, but I took a lot of confidence, but I took it as a challenge and thought, well, okay. And, you know, for a guy like me who's highly competitive, Jamie knew how to push my buttons, and, you know, he really pushed one with me. And I remember on the flight to Wellington one time, I did a tip tackle on a guy once, and I was in trouble. And me and Jamie had to go up to Wellington to a hearing. And on the flight up, he said, do you think you can start for the Highlanders? I said, oh, yeah, Jimmy's pretty good. And he goes, but do you think you could be better than Jimmy Cowan? And I thought, no, at the time. But he said, I think if you keep tracking how you're going, keep working really hard, I think you could beat him one day. And I thought, oh, yeah. And he goes, I think you could be an All Black if you keep at it and keep your head down and keep working hard. And I was sitting there going, far out. And, you know, like, man, I'm in trouble here. And he's like, oh, don't worry about this stuff. And I actually got downgraded to a yellow, and I didn't miss any games. But that stuck with me. And he said, I think you could be an All Black if you commit and back yourself. And, yeah, a year later, I was able to achieve that. But if he hadn't had that combo, would I have trained as hard in that preseason? And he said to me at the end of that season, I'll pick the best halfback for this team next year. And if that's you, I'll pick you. But you got to show me. And I thought, and a guy like me, I don't need much fuel or anything. And I really took it to heart and came back. And I was in the best shape of my life I'd been at the time. And was able to build a, you know, to make the All Blacks, you've got to have consistency and play really well. But I also got lucky that Steve Hansen saw something as well and gave me an opportunity. And man, a lot of things, you know, the stadium, Jamie Joseph, a new coach, and Steve Hansen and the All Blacks saw he wanted to play a different way, maybe a faster way. And yeah, I'm very lucky with a few things in my career, but I made sure that when I got chances, I really try to take them and have no regrets. And I leave Dunedin with none, because I've given this jersey everything I could, and this city and the team have given me everything I could dream of.
How important has it been for you to leave the jersey? Like, people talk about leaving the jersey in a better place, but how important has it been for you to do that?
Well, at the start, I was a bench player behind Jimmy Cowan, the All Black incumbent halfback, and I didn't really think it was a big deal, you know. I was just trying to learn off him and stuff. But the further you get on, the longer I've been in the team, trying to, oh, okay, could I maybe get more games than Jimmy? He played 100 games in 2012 when I was on the team with him as well. And I thought, oh, you know, he's our greatest halfback. And I was like, oh, okay, well, there's a challenge. There's an opportunity. And why couldn't you get more games than him? Didn't mean you'd be better or anything, but why not? And then it was, okay, and then I got more games than Jimmy, and then it was like, what's the next goal? And I saw Bender get 150 games, and that was sort of the, okay, let's be the same as Bender. I'd love that. We have cheese cutters, and they've got stars on them for every 50 you play. And I saw Bender get one with 3 stars, and I had 2. And I love challenges, and I love trying to chase things. And, you know, the longer you play, the luckier you get, the closer these opportunities come for achieving goals and stuff. And I've ticked every goal this year so far for the Highlanders, except for the playoffs. And that's like all I'm focused on, is I want to make the playoffs in my last year. And we've made it for the last, since 2014, sometimes we're snucking, sometimes we're in the easy, but we've been in there since 2014. And I want to, one more look at it, and I hope that, I hope we can win on Friday night.
Next year, Folau takes the reins. Like, you know, you're going to give him the keys. How important is it that he treasures those keys and grows with them as well?
Well, last year when there was a lot of talk about him leaving, I sort of said to him, hey, like, you know, we can both make the All Blacks here. You don't have to go. And it was right. He made the All Blacks last year and we were both there, two Highlanders halfbacks from one team. So I was happy that happened for him. But then I also said to him too is, you don't have to have the challenge and the burden of, just be you, mate. And Falau Fakatava is amazing. And he will be. And he's the future of our club. And Sean Withey's, the Finn Hurley's, the Cam Miller's, the Fabian Hollands, they're the future. And that's what our team's about. And with Billy, and then when it's their time to take the reins as leaders and take this team to where they want to take it, there's no burden around that. And I've always been like that, and I don't want to put any pressure on Falau or anything. I want him to be the best version of him. Same with James Ascott and Nathan Hasty. Whoever becomes the guy, you don't know who it's going to be, but they'll do their best, and there's no burden or pressure from me, like, don't muck it up. I wasn't perfect my whole career either. I had bad years and I've had bad games, but I just hope I leave a legacy of hard work, dedication and commitment to the jersey, and just inspire young men, more young men in New Zealand, to just chase your goals and you know, have ambition to dream big. And I've always dreamt real big, and I always try to work really hard to achieve that. And people will doubt it. You will doubt yourself too, but I always thought, have a crack. Write a goal and go for it. And loftier the better, because if you settle short, that's where you'll fall. I've just tried to be, with media or anything, as open and honest and just be real. And I don't think anyone can doubt I'm never real about something. And on the field, you can see what I'm feeling because of my face. I carry what I wear my heart on my sleeve, you know. If I'm gutted, I'm gutted. And if I'm happy, I'm happy. And it doesn't matter if it's a knock-on or a match-winning try or a scrum penalty. I'll celebrate the good and the bad.
That 2015 year, like, how special was that moment and that team?
Yeah, when you look back now, like, from the perspective of my last time and last year and stuff, you're just happy we got it done once. You know, like, some people up the road maybe can say, yeah, how many time champions are they? They're heaps, you know. But for our team, for that team, and we got it right one year, and it was so special and still the highlight of my career. I had a lot of things, but nothing will beat that feeling. The Highlanders won Super Rugby. And with the team we had some superstars, there's no doubt. And we had some battlers as well. But it just showed what a team can do when you get it right. And we weren't the best team that year by far. The Hurricanes were outstanding. But we got it right on the night. And that's all that matters. In a final, anything can happen. And we had a really good plan. We had a band of brothers that loved each other, a brotherhood. And it's still the bond that group will have forever. We all remember that year. We all remember the bond we had. And it's funny, when I see all my old teammates and stuff, it's good to see them, but when you see one of those boys from that year, you have a different bond. That's like that one time we got it right. And yeah, it's like no sweeter feeling. Like, I won the World Cup that year as well, and it didn't feel like that. It's different. But like, for the Highlanders, it was such a buzz because, like we said, no one believed us, even our families, and maybe some of us, I didn't believe fully either. But when we got onto the game, belief grows, we were getting ahead, we were nailing moments, the plan was working, and we still, you know, they had a couple of moments that could have stole the game as well, but it fell our way. And I've played a lot of rugby, and you look at those games and you go, wow, and thank you. I've been chasing that ever since, to try and win another one, you know. But nothing will recapture that feeling for me, I think. But 2015, man, was special, and it's forever.